over 2 months ago, the RCHS Drama Club decided to pick my script for their spring play. I didn't know how to feel when they chose my script, like something that I just started 3 months prior was going to be performed in May. It didn't feel real. Later, I told my band director, Miss Bassett, about how my show was going to be performed by the RCHS Drama Club. I'm pretty sure her jaw hit the floor. She was a lot more excited than I was for myself, and it wasn't really until that moment that I realized the magnitude of this. I remember the moment when I suddenly realized, hey, this is going to be performed, and that terrified me. This script, this thing I've been working on since November, was finally going to be performed. Last week, I was sitting in the audience of the OCC Jazz Fest, and I happened to pick up a program. Inside the cover was a program note written by my band director. This snippet really stuck with me. Life's too short to live afraid and let fear hold you back. Sometimes you just have to trust and to leap. It's in those moments when we don't know how it's really going to end up and that we find, truly, that we are alive, a living, breathing part of the wonderful world, uncertain beauty around us. With Innocent, I had to trust and to leap. I trusted this amazing group of high schoolers to take my work and bring it to life, and they followed through. I would like to thank my family for dealing with my crazy, ever-changing schedule, to Emma Roark and Mr. Ryden for editing a really rough draft of my show, to Miss Bassett for showing me the power of vulnerability and helping me improve as a performer and as a writer. To Miss Skinder, Emma Corey, Hunter Merritt, and the cast and crew of Innocent for having faith in my script and in the show, and to you, the audience. Without your support for the arts, we would be performing for an empty stage tonight, empty theater tonight. Thank you for your attention and enjoy the show.
Why do you say that?
Because I wasn't.
That's not an answer.
What do you want from me?
Just tell me what happened, Miss Richardson.
My mom came home from work, and I ran into her in the dining room. I usually run into her making dinner, but for some reason she didn't come home as she usually did.
How does this tie in with the story?
It will.
All right, I guess.
Aren't you going to eat something before you pick Alicia up from school?
No, Alicia has play practice this week, and she said she wouldn't get done until about 8. In the meantime, I'm going to the store to pick up something for Lila's birthday.
Oh, so you're headed back out?
Yeah. Oh, and I heard something in the backyard, and I was taking out the trash. I wouldn't go back there if I were you.
I'll just stay inside then.
Well, I'm going to go. I want to be home before Lila gets back from her scholar project.
Okay, bye.
Bye.
As soon as she left, I went to the backyard. A few feet from the back porch, there was a gun lying on the ground. My mistake was picking it up. I figured since it was so close to my house that it just fell out of someone's holster. So I tucked it in my jacket and kept walking. I figured I could return it to a person who dropped. I didn't realize the red splatters across the surface of the gun. I found her a few minutes later. Her face was caked with a mixture of mud and blood. I can't remember if I screamed or not.
Lindsay Odell?
Oh my God, Lindsay!
What did you do? What did you do?
I didn't do anything.
You killed her.
This isn't what it looks like. I didn't do anything. I don't even own a gun.
Then where did you get that one?
I found it behind my house. I thought someone dropped it. Why wouldn't you believe me?
Why would they believe someone like you?
You probably killed Lindsay, so...
I apologize. I didn't mean for her to get hurt.
Your rumors about Lindsay suspended.
My friend has just been shot. My name is Madeline Fitcher. Yes, I'm at Juliana. Juliana!
have waited for the police to show up and told them what happened.
It was their word against mine. I didn't have any other choice.
What happened next?
I ran away. I didn't know where I was going. But the only thing I did know is that I needed to get as far away from Lindsay's body as I possibly could. I had to escape this nightmare. A while later, I spotted a small brick house in the middle of nowhere. It was late, but I needed help. There was a light inside, so I figured someone was awake. So I knocked on the door and waited for someone to open it.
Then Ira Lane showed up, correct?
Miss Lane opened the door and just stood there. She was wearing a coat, so I figured she was getting ready to go somewhere, but I didn't know why she was planning on going somewhere this late at night.
Hello?
Oh, hi. My car broke down and my phone's dead. I was wondering if I could use your phone?
Oh, yes, dear. Come inside. You look like you're freezing. I'll make you some cocoa while you make yourself comfortable.
You lied to her.
I didn't have any other choice. If I told her the truth, she would have called the cops on me. I would have been arrested right then and there.
Okay, wait a second. So you lied to her, so she would have called the cops on you?
Yes.
But what if Ira saw the news that morning and knew you were a wanted criminal?
That had crossed my mind. I just hope she hadn't watched the news yet.
So you just happened to stumble upon this woman who didn't know you, didn't ask any questions, and just let you into her house.
I swear, I've never seen this woman before in my life.
Are you sure about that?
Can I just tell you the story instead of you grilling me about my relationship with Miss Lane?
Fine, but keep in mind that these questions will come up later.
Miss Lane led me to her living room and sat me down on the couch. And continued to get ready for, well, I don't know where she was planning on going this late at night.
What's your name, miss?
Tanya. Tanya Conwell.
You gave her a fake name?
Again, I didn't have any other choice. I didn't want her to know my real name.
You could have.
I couldn't let her know my real name, Miss Brooks. End of discussion.
Well, Tanya, I'm gonna go make you some cocoa like I had promised. There's a phone charger on the side table that you can use to charge your phone, and if it's not the right kind, then you can just use my little phone.
Miss Lane just continued to get ready for work. I knew I didn't have my phone with me, so I just picked up the magazine and pretended I was reading it.
Did the charger work with your phone?
Oh, I didn't realize till now that I left my phone back in my car. I didn't think I needed it since it was dead.
Oh, well, you can just use my phone after you're done with your drink.
Okay, thank you, Mrs.
Miss Lane?
Oh, well, thank you for the cocoa, Miss Lane.
It's no problem. I work the graveyard shift at the Main Street Gas, and I trust you not to take anything. Just lock the doors and turn off the lights when you leave.
Okay, thank you.
It's no problem. The same thing happened to me a few years ago, except my car didn't break down. I just forgot to put gas in it.
Miss Lane continued to tell me a story about how she was stranded on the side of the road for 3 hours when she was 16. I tried to listen to her, but I kept thinking, what if? What if Miss Lane's just stalling until the police get here? What if I get caught? What if I hurt someone else? What if?
Oh my gosh, I have to be at work soon and I'm not even ready. I'm sorry, I'll have to tell you this story some other time.
So, as she's getting ready for work, what do you do?
I just continue drinking my cocoa. Miss Lane was so worried about getting ready that she just completely ignored me.
I'm going to go now. My phone number is on the fridge if you need it. And if I don't answer my cell, you can just call the gas station where I work.
Okay, thank you.
No problem. Bye, Tanya.
No, goodbye. As soon as she left, I went to the kitchen to borrow some food.
You can't borrow food, Miss Richardson. You stole from her.
I felt bad for stealing from Miss Lane. She seemed so nice. But I didn't know when I would eat next. I could starve before I got caught by the police.
According According to Arlo Lane's phone records, you called your parents around 11:45 that night. The police... Wait. I don't understand. You say that you're innocent. You say you don't want to get caught, but why did you call your parents? If you didn't want to get caught, why would you call home?
And I didn't want figured my family would be a little worried about me. So I called them.
A little worried.
I have two other sisters, Layla and Alicia. Layla's a senior in high school, and Alicia's only a freshman. They get all the attention. Me? I just get forgotten. I honestly wouldn't be surprised if they did forget about me.
How does this tie in with the story, Miss Richardson?
My mom's really protective of my two sisters. I'm the middle child. The middle child always gets forgotten.
Just continue.
I knew my mom would be up, so I called her. I didn't think my sisters would be up since it's school night.
Hello?
Mom?
Where are you, Juliana?
We're on speakerphone.
Mom?
Hello? Who is this?
I shouldn't have called him. My mom knew it was me on the phone. She was trying to protect me. I should have hung up.
What about the officers?
I didn't know they were there. I didn't want my family to worry about me. So I called them. Sue me.
Juliana, you might want to watch your word choice.
Just, whatever.
Hello? Who is this?
Sorry, wrong number.
Who was that?
It was a wrong number.
This late at night, I doubt it.
It was a wrong number.
Miss Richardson, can we talk in private?
I guess I'll show you to the kitchen. Layla?
Yeah?
Do you think that was Julie?
On the phone?
Yeah.
I don't know, it could have been her.
Do you think she killed Lindsay?
Honestly, I don't know.
Julie couldn't have killed Lindsay, though. I remember when I was 7, Julie Baldwin was on a spotted goldfish. Last week, she cried when Mom killed the bat in the attic. Julie's too sensitive.
I want to believe she's innocent, Alicia. I really do, but there's too much evidence pointed against her.
How could you say that? You think your own sister killed someone?
I'm not saying she did, Alicia, but we can't eliminate that possibility. She went missing after she was found with the murder weapon.
Isn't that not the least bit suspicious?
Juliana would never leave!
The police forced it out of your mother. They began to trace the call even before she told Officer Ranger who was on the other end of the line. All they needed was Arlo Lane's phone number, and they could trace her number back to your location. But you didn't know that, did you, Juliana?
No, I didn't.
They had you.
They found me. I had to run.
Entire house, but they couldn't find you anywhere.
They found me. I had to run.
Juliana, you didn't have to run. You could have waited for the police to get there, tell them what happened, and it would have saved so much time.
If I would have confessed to the crime, that would not have been good.
By running, it just made yourself look more guilty.
What other choice did I have? There were 3 witnesses. I'm the key suspect.
The police said they looked throughout Arlo Lane's whole entire property and still couldn't find you. Did that scare you?
I was in the middle of the night. There were people with guns looking for me. How do you think I felt? Thrilled? Excited? Happy that I was finally getting attention for once?
Miss Richardson, do you think so? sarcastic remarks are the best thing to use right now.
Do you want me to continue?
Sure.
At that point, I was in the middle of the forest.
Do you know what happened to your family when you were running?
Of course not. I was in the middle of nowhere. How was I supposed to know what was happening to them?
Your family was told of your last known location, which was Irla Lane's residence. And they claimed you nor Irla Lane knew each other.
That's correct. We never met before that night.
Miss Lane was brought in for questioning shortly after you fled her property. She told us that she didn't hear about the Odell murder until that morning at work. We showed her a picture, and she recognized you immediately.
Yeah, that's Tanya. This girl's name is actually Juliana Richardson. She's the person of interest in the Odell murder.
We found some of her blood-soaked clothes at your house. We were wondering why they're in your trash can.
Wait, she told me her name was Tanya. I've never seen that girl before a day in my life before that night. She told me she needed help, and so I helped her. I was trying to be nice. What was I supposed to do? Let her freeze to death outside?
You helped her?
I didn't know she was a wanted criminal, okay? I've never seen that girl before a day in my life, like I said. She said she needed help, and so I helped her, okay? You can search my entire property. I have nothing to hide.
We'll be taking you in for questioning, Miss Lane.
What about my job? I need the money.
We'll talk to your manager, Miss Lane.
Miss Lane didn't know that I took advantage of her. I regret that. She's innocent. She doesn't deserve to go to jail because of something that I did.
Juliana, Miss Lane could be charged with harboring a fugitive.
I wish I could apologize. She doesn't deserve to be punished because of me.
While they were talking to Miss Lane, some officers were searching your house.
For evidence? Miss Brooks, I never went back to my house after I left Lindsay's body.
They were looking for it. We have a lot of evidence against you, but we need to know more than just what you were telling us. We needed to know what happened privately between you and Lindsay. And they found plenty of evidence.
Have to talk about this right now?
You'll have to tell me sometime or later.
Can I just continue with my story?
Yeah, sure.
I was lost again.
Stop trying to be all theatrical about it and get to the point.
Fine. I don't know how long I was walking. One minute I was at Miss Lane's house, the next I was on some rope. Nobody knew where I was. That was both terrifying, yet relaxing at the same time. There was no one walking on the road, so I decided to take advantage of my loneliness and walk on the road. The only place I wanted to go was home.
Then why didn't you go home?
I didn't want to hurt anyone else.
You could have gone home. You could have turned yourself in.
If I went home, I could have hurt someone else. I didn't want to do that.
So you're walking down the road. Continue.
I was walking down the road for about an hour or so. Couldn't find a place to hide, so I only had another choice. It was to keep walking.
And then what happened?
It's got to be around here somewhere.
Well, we wouldn't be out here if you didn't decide to stick your phone out the window. Brilliant idea, Alexis.
Well, you're a
Really, Alexis? I'm a bad driver? You've got two speakerphones.
Let's see how many iPhones.
None. And I've never had to look for my phone in the middle of a sketchy back road at 1:30 morning because I dropped it out of a moving vehicle.
Well, you... I mean, I... Fine, I'm an idiot. Can we move on now?
This road is a sketchy etch a sketch. You got to admit, that's pretty good fun.
Sorry, I went for a walk and I guess I got lost. I found this phone on the ground and I overheard you two talking about one. Don't worry, I didn't go through it. I didn't want to look like a creepy stalker when I tried to return it to you guys.
Thank you.
Actually, could I borrow this? I don't know where I am and I need to call my mom. I need a ride.
Can I talk to Alexis for a second?
Sure.
Do you really trust her using your phone? Don't you remember how I said this forest is sketchy?
Yeah, it's sketchy. But I feel bad for her.
Fine, let her use your phone, but don't come crying to me when she runs off with it.
You can use it as long as you promise not to steal it.
Really? Thank you so much. Hello? Oh my god, Layla, is that you?
Yeah. Oh my gosh, Julie?
Is that Juliana? Juliana, this is Officer Ranger from the Northdale Police Department.
Yes. It's me, Juliana.
Juliana, please come home, I swear!
Juliana, please listen to me. You have to stop running. They will catch you.
I know, but I can't.
Juliana, please listen. She hung up on me.
Doesn't matter if she hung up. We already know where she called from.
They found her?
Yes, they found her. Because she should be in custody within the next 10 minutes. If she cooperates.
She'll cooperate.
Are you sure about that?
Well, she's not stupid enough to fight a police officer. And she can't just keep running. She's already been running for hours now. What's going to stop her from running again?
Julie knows she has to stop running eventually. Thanks for letting me borrow this. I'll be on my way.
Is someone giving you a ride? We could give a ride to that baby's your family.
We can?
Of course we can!
Thanks for the offer, but I'll be okay.
Juliana? Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Where's Juliana?
She went that way!
Alicia, in private.
I guess you two can go to the living room. Is this about Julie?
Of course it's about Julie! The last thing I always went about Julie. When haven't we talked about Julie?
Sorry, I'm just scared, that's all.
What do you think would happen if Julie was charged with murder?
Honestly, I don't know. I could. couldn't fathom her killing someone. I want to believe that she's innocent, but
it's not like our opinions matter anyway. The jury wouldn't take our side, or her sister's.
Do you know what Mom thinks happened to Julie?
I don't think I want to know what Mom thinks.
They've arrested Juliana.
How long ago did this happen? Where was she?
They arrested her a few miles outside of town about 20 minutes ago. But she was still in the county in our jurisdiction, so they arrested her. We found a few girls with her. They think that she used one of their phones to make the call.
Is she all right?
Did they find her?
Yes, Alicia, they found Julie.
Assaulting an officer. Resisting arrest, murder, tampering with evidence, fleeing the scene of a crime. Juliana, you're in some hot water.
I'm innocent.
It's gonna be tough to convince the jury that.
What do you want from me?
I want to know what really happened.
What exactly do you want to know?
If you want even the slightest chance of walking scot-free, you're gonna have to tell the truth, okay? What happened?
It was stupid.
Well, why do you say that?
About 3 months ago. I accidentally said something about Lindsay that I shouldn't have. It spread like wildfire.
Neither you nor Lindsay stated the problem outright. Is there maybe a possibility that it was a misunderstanding?
Oh no, there was no misunderstanding. We both knew exactly what was going on. In fact, she confronted me about the problem several times.
You're dancing around the question, Miss Richardson. Tell me what the fight was about.
You should be able to figure that out from the text that we sent each other. You know, since you took my phone.
Okay. But we need more than that, okay? Now, you said you were in the English class, correct?
She would constantly pester me.
Okay, well, what happened in English class? Please tell me.
I may have told one of my friends that I saw Lindsay with a can of tobacco in English class.
Okay, did you actually see her with it?
Yes, I did. Anyway, our school has an insanely strict tobacco policy. They take each complaint seriously. So when I told someone...
Who was the someone?
Mrs. Grady. Anyway, I told Mrs. Grady that I saw Lindsay pull a container of tobacco out of her backpack during English class. She just put a piece in her mouth without even caring about who was watching her. After I told the teacher her backpack got confiscated, and they searched through her locker, they found gum container after gum container of tobacco in her locker. She ended up getting suspended.
And how did Lindsay react to this?
She got extremely angry. She sent me a text the minute after she got suspended, told me that she beat me up as soon as she got back from suspension.
What happened after she got back to school?
Well, well, well. Look who it is. Little Miss Teacher's pet.
Hello, Lindsay.
Well, would you look at the time? Looks like it's time for you to kick your...
Quick off, Lindsay. I'm not!
Aw, you're chicken! Hey, break it up, girls! Come, beat it up, one of them!
Lindsay ended up getting suspended. Again. And this might only make things worse.
What happened after that?
Be able to figure that out from the text we sent each other. You know, since she took my phone.
Okay, I'm gonna tell you this one more time. We have texts, we have evidence, but we need to know what happens face to face. That stuff is not documented. You know, Lindsay knows. Lindsay's not here. I'm asking you. What happened face to face?
She would constantly test her. Lindsay's friends would stare me down every time I walked to English class. They had nothing better to do than make my life miserable.
Is that all?
A few weeks ago, Lindsay tried to get me to fight her again. I punched her in the jaw and caused her mouth to bleed. We both got suspended.
Okay, hold on. You were mad that she got you suspended. That gave you motive to kill her.
I didn't kill Lindsay.
Is that the end of the story?
You should check Madeline's, Grace's, and Elise's text that they sent me. Her little minions wouldn't leave me alone. That one girl, Grace,
we are not interested with their interaction with Lindsay. They didn't kill Lindsay, now did they? We're only interested in your interaction, Miss Richardson. Is there anything else you would like to add?
No.
Okay, well, looks like we're done here.
Do my parents know that I was
arrested?
Yeah.
Yes, Juliana, they know.
Okay.
Thank you. guess I'm all right.
They probably already told you, but we got you an attorney. He's one of the best in the—
Mom, you didn't have to do that.
It's the only thing we could do for you.
No, really, you— Thank you, Mom. How are Alicia and Layla? They doing okay?
Alicia's been doing better than I thought she would, although someday she'll come to school and she won't talk to anyone. She'll lock herself in a room for hours on end and blast her music through her speakers, but we can still hear her sobbing. Layla, on the other hand, has been more level-headed. She's been so calm through all of this. I mean, I'm not saying Layla— I'll let you talk to Layla. She's been dying to talk to you. Bye, Julie.
Bye, Mom.
Julie?
Hi, Layla.
I know you have a time constraint, so I'll try to be brief.
Okay.
I miss you. We all miss you. I wish you had the opportunity for bail, but given the circumstances, I'll let you talk to Alicia now. She needs to hear you more than I do.
Okay.
Bye, Julie.
Bye, Layla.
Oh my gosh, hi, Julie.
Hi, Alicia.
I can't wait to see you.
The next time you see me will be at the trial. Do you really want to see me dressed as an orange traffic cone?
I mean, we haven't seen you for a while. It'll be nice to see you.
I miss you guys too. I hope we get a chance to talk face to face sometime before the trial.
Hey, you know what we should do for the trial?
What?
We should go out to eat. Like, we could go to Chinese or that pizza place you like, or we could just grab a gallon of ice cream and have it on my meal.
I'd like that.
Wrap it up.
I'm sorry, Alicia. I've gotta go.
Alrighty.
Yeah, can you put Mom back on the phone?
Okay, bye, Julie.
Bye, Alicia.
Hey, Julie Bug.
Hi, Mom. My time's almost up, so I'll try and be brief. Thank you for not giving up on me. It's nice to know that there's at least one person on my side.
I love you.
I love you too.
See you soon, Julie.
See you soon, Mom.
Let's go.
Anyone take my side?
Because nobody believes the girl with blood on her hands.
I'm innocent. I'm telling the truth.
You killed me.
I hope Alicia's right. I hope they realize I'm innocent.
You're not innocent, Juliana. You shot me. I'm dead.
I just hope they believe me when I tell them the truth. When I tell them it was an accident.
You're not walking out of here scot-free for killing me!
It was self-defense.
It wasn't self-defense, Juliana! Forget it. Good night, murderer.
Your story doesn't add up with everyone else's, Juliana.
Are you assuming I'm the one lying? Maybe one of Lindsay's friends are lying.
By Lindsay's friends, you mean Madeline Fitcher, Elise Reese, and Grace Newberry?
Yes, those were the girls at the crime scene.
Stop dodging the question.
I'm not dodging the question.
You're hiding something.
I'm not.
That answer was a little too quick for me to believe, Juliana.
I didn't mean to hurt her. It was self-defense.
That makes no sense. You said you found the gun—
I was terrified, okay? I was caught with the murder weapon. I ran away. I had her blood on my hands. Why would anyone believe that I'm innocent?
Just tell me what happened.
I was getting out of my car when I noticed something in the tree line a few yards away. So I went to investigate. Out of nowhere, Lindsay appeared, gun in hand. She said, "Glad you decided to show up. A place they can finally finish this." I told her she was insane. I wasn't going to fight her.
Wuss,
she replied.
"I'm surprised you didn't start another rumor about me."
"I'm sorry," I said. "We both know this was an accident. I didn't mean for it to end that way."
"With me being suspended?"
She waved her gun around and remarked how her father got it for Christmas.
That gun was an early Christmas present from him. Unfortunately, I never got the chance to use it because somebody else pulled the trigger.
She aimed the gun at me, demanded I call Elise and tell her I was currently having an affair with her boyfriend, Logan. I told her I didn't have my phone with me, which was the truth.
"I didn't believe you. And I also don't believe that you shot me in self-defense. You still shot me, Juliana. I'm still dead."
Lindsay wanted revenge for the rumors that started from her suspension. She wanted to let me know how she felt.
How she felt about the rumors?
Lindsay wanted me to know how it felt to walk down the halls at school and have people stare at you like you're some kind of animal. She wanted me to know what it's like to have people not trust you. She wanted to let me know how I ruined her life, and she wanted to ruin mine.
Was she going to shoot you if you did not cooperate?
No.
Honestly, I don't know. We never gotten that far.
Well, we wouldn't be here if someone had cooperated.
As she was getting her phone, I tried to wrestle the gun from her hand. I guess the safety was off and someone pulled the trigger.
You pulled it!
Her body went limp in my arms.
The last thing that I saw was your damn face.
I don't know who screamed louder, me or her.
Pretty sure I screamed louder. I'm also pretty sure you don't regret pulling the trigger.
Her blood was all over my hands. It was all over my clothes.
I think there was more clothes on my— no. I think there was more blood on my clothes, Juliana, considering I'm the one who got shot.
I don't know how long it was before friends showed up. I don't think it was too long.
How is a jury supposed to believe you when you have two stories of the same event?
I'm telling the truth.
Okay, then why do you have two stories? Why did you lie?
There are three witnesses at the crime scene. One of those three girls videoed me next to Lindsay's body. My fingerprints are on the gun, Miss Brooks. For God's sake, my DNA is on her body. No sane jury would let me go on a self-defense charge with that much evidence against me. I wouldn't let a person like myself get away with murder. Why would anyone else let me go if I wouldn't even let a person like myself walk scot-free?
See, the thing is, Juliana, you're not innocent.
Okay. If you would have told me the truth in the beginning, maybe the jury would have believed you, but now we have two stories going on, and they're not going to believe you, Juliana. It's going to be very hard.
I
I don't know what you want me to do. I'm not your lawyer.
There's not really much to say then, I guess.
We have two stories of the same event. How is she going to believe you? How is anybody going to believe you, Juliana? You have to tell me the truth.
I was the last person to see her. There's no plausible explanation as to why I was by her body with a gun in my hand.
Okay, it is my job to force the truth out of people. I don't like my job, I'll be honest. It sucks, okay? I try not to pick sides, but it's really hard. There's a teen dead, and no one is charged with her murder. It's easy to point fingers.
Exactly. It's easy to point fingers because all the evidence points to me. I'm innocent, but it's hard to defend that when my fingerprints are on the gun.
If you had told the truth, or at least the right version of it, in the first place, we wouldn't be here, Juliana. You know what? We wouldn't be here if you hadn't shot me.
Okay, I'm gonna go back to what you said about self-defense. Because I feel like I need to educate you, okay? Self-defense does not mean that you walk, as I quote you, scot-free. Self-defense does not make you a free person. Self-defense means that you confess to the crime, okay? Now, you say you're innocent. A self-defense charge does not change that. The only thing that does change is if you go to jail or not. The only way that a self-defense charge could end up in favor of you, the defendant, is if the defendant is
I'm innocent.
No, listen to me, Juliana. The only way that a self-defense charge can end up in favor of you is if the defendant is a trustworthy source. And seeing as you have two stories of the same event, that's going to be pretty hard. They're not going to believe you, Juliana. You can't get away with a self-defense.
I'm telling the truth.
Please.
I think we're done here.
Here you go.
Thanks. Hey, you want to get some custom in the kitchen? We can make some McRiblets.
Julie's name. I like that.
Expect a calm before the storm. 12 hours of the trial, and I'm scared. I don't really know how to feel, but I know that whatever happens, the verdict will be just. I mean, it's kind of my fault that we're here. I mean, well, Juliana, she was the one who started the rumors. And I tried to put a stop to them. It's... But in the end, I brought the gun. If I had known how this whole ordeal would have turned out, I wouldn't have brought that gun with me. I said I wanted to humiliate you, but this? I wouldn't wish this on anyone. Your family needs you, Juliana. And I took you. As your finger brushed the trigger, your entire body froze. Your eyes widened with fear. Then I collapsed. you by my side and you tried to stop the bleeding. You kept telling me you were sorry. Juliana, this whole time I thought that you wanted to kill me, but you only shot me because you were scared. Juliana, you were scared as hell. Juliana, I'm sorry. I'll leave you alone now. Goodbye, Juliana.
You have visitors.